Hi everyone, Emily here. Today I'm going to be bringing you guys a question that I got in from a subscriber of mine, Connie Keene. Connie, let me know if I said that correctly. I'm sorry if I said your last name wrong. I think I got the Connie part right. So Connie's question was really interesting, and I wanted to bring this out to the, you know, YouTube artistic community. Connie wrote that it seems like that I never run out of ideas. How do you know when a piece is done? Is there a point where you say finished? So if you guys don't know, I am a makeup artist, and on this channel I do a lot of creative makeup looks. And what Connie's talking about is, when do I know when my makeup look is complete or when it's finished? But this can also follow in the genre of like painters and digital artists and, you know, other artist subjects as well, not just makeup. I look back once I think I'm done. I look at everything, and then just from experience, I can tell if I am finished or not. That's basically summarizing it all, is experience and knowing what you want for your art piece. Just to get in a little bit of detail, to help with creating your piece so it doesn't go overboard, because let me tell you, I've been through it all the time. I've done looks that just looks really messy, and you know, like I kind of overdid it, and then it tends to look tacky, like it just been done before. You know, and you also want to not only create a complete look but also have it look original. So some things that have helped me in the past of creating makeup looks are brainstorming. So for some people, they might sketch it out. For some people, they might do face charts, you know, when it comes to makeup. For me, I actually talk out loud. I think in pictures and designs, so it's easier for me to like talk out loud and think what I'm saying. It sounds so weird saying it out loud, but that's just how I do it. I just talk out loud what I'm going to be doing. So for example, if I'm going to be doing something colorful, I say, okay, I'm going to be doing color over here on the side of my temples, and I'm going to be bringing it down to my chest. So I envision that, and then I start doing it. And what really helped me is, after each step of creating the makeup look, I step back and I look at the complete look, whether it's on myself or on someone else. I look at the complete look, and I'll know if it needs to be added or to stop right there. Brainstorming is very important for anything that you do in life, because at least for me, my thoughts are all over the place, so it's really important to get organized mentally before creating a certain project or an artistic piece. So one thing I do want to throw out there really quick is, there's different types of artists, so look at your type of inspirations and your favorite artist out there that you just love their type of work. And if you want to have similar taste, then replicate their look and then change a couple things. That's how you become more unique, because you can grab a couple things from other artists that you like and then subtract or add from it. Also, it's kind of more likely to get judged on a art piece when you replicate it from someone else, or when you copy it from another artist, because people have seen it before and they know what looks really good, or they know who does it really good and who doesn't. So when you do it, it's kind of like, it's a lot of pressure on you. So, you know, in order to create something that's unique to the eye and unique to your style, you know, definitely put in your own flair into it and create something new for everyone to see, and create your own unique collection for someone else in the future to look at your collection and be like, oh, I want to grab some of that, you know, or some of this. So there's different types of artists out there. There's artists that are very intricate with their work, that are really precise. For example, like henna, very detailed, precise work, and it looks like a lot, but it works because it's in an organized pattern. And then there's some artists who are very simplistic, very bold graphic design, nothing too precise. So you just, you know, figure out what you like to do and what you feel is easier for you to do. For me, like when it comes to really intricate work, that's something I'm like still learning and still practicing, but I do love it. So when it comes to finishing a piece, experience is the number one thing. You'll know what you have done in the past to know what not to do in the future, or to know what to do in the future. At the end of the day, makeup has no rules. Don't listen to what anyone says, because if you're happy doing what you are creating and what you are in the zone, like if you get in the zone when you do certain things, like that's really good. Art is like a form of meditation. So if you're doing something and you're not enjoying it and you're stressing out about it because you can't do it, you need to switch it up. That means that particular look is not for you. Don't give up if you know for a fact that when you are creating, whether it's makeup or any type of artistic piece or whatever you're creating in your life, and you feel good about it, then keep doing it and eventually you will find your own signature look. Again, thank you, Connie, for, you know, writing in that question. And if any of you guys have any questions for me about this topic or anything else, I will be really happy to answer that for you. And until then, I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.